Evening folks, this is BestInSlot and welcome back to the final episode of this part of the Planet Zoo campaign. We're going to finish off Maya's Rainforest Conservation Project thingamajiggy as I readjust myself massively. In the last video we added ourselves our bed tapir and our lovely little tropical habitat over here. And now to finish things off we're going to focus on Linlin. Linlin is of course our great panda, our giant panda. There she is, Linlin. We're going to get her into the park and then we're going to finish off by getting our yearly profit up to 15,000. So we're going to ignore the profit for now, although I have no money whatsoever, I've just realised. And then we're going to, anyways, let's just get started. So the goal is to actually build something fairly Asian inspired, just because it's Linlin. She's, you know, she's come over from Asia, I assume. And I think that'll be cool. And I think it'll look pretty funky. And you know how I like funky things, to have a big sort of Asian-inspired exhibit in the middle of the Brazilian rainforest. I think that's going to be very cool, so that's what we're going to do. Null barrier, save myself some moolah. Got a little bit of a plan in mind. Nothing too unique, but something pretty cool. We're going in hard on this one, folks. I'm also distracting myself from the football. Okay, let's go there, and then let's grab the end of that and curl it into there. Make that a little baby. Curl, and curl, and curl. There we go. That is Linlin's habitat. We might... I'm just thinking about this. I think if we bring Linlin in right now, that'll work out well for us, just because it'll increase our revenue instantly. Like, we can then focus on making go. Like, we'll make her happy on a very basic level, and then we'll build the exhibit, I think is the idea. Are you guys all right? What's going on? Okay. Nothing's gone on, so I don't know what their problem is, but they're not loving life, are they? Okay, come on then, Linlin. Welcome to the park. More storage, and boop. She's got a big exhibit all to herself. I'm sure she'll have a whale of a time. Now, what we need to do is grab ourselves the terrain tool. So my idea is basically to build like a mountain scene here at the back, and then at the top of the mountain, like a Asian-inspired pagoda sort of thing, something like that. I don't really know, but it's gonna work. It's gonna be cool. And cool things are cool. So let's just set this back bit up. I want it to be very clearly multi-tiered, if that makes sense, and it does. So let's go around there. Might have to screw around with the boundary a little bit, otherwise Linlin's gonna just wander out and do her own thing. The rebel that Linlin is. Right, I wanna come... I really should have thought this through in my head. I'm gonna bring that one round. I'm just thinking of like a little waterfall. I think this needs to be much higher. I think that's part of the problem. So we're gonna get nice and tall over here. Yee. Flatten that out, flatten that out, flatten that out, make it sexy. It's a shame that I don't know if there's a way to do it, but to when your mountain is very, very tall and you click flatten, it doesn't flatten all the way down to the bottom. It kind of makes this gap that you can see here, right? It's not that hard to fix, but it is mildly annoying. You come over here. Okay. We may be slightly making this up as we go along. That's okay. All right, Linlin is here. Can Linlin currently, can she just wander up the mountain is what I need to find out. No, Linlin is actually very well contained. That is perfect. So, we can keep Linlin, well, what we should do. We should make Linlin happy on like a very basic level. And then we're going to build the exhibit around Linlin. I do want to keep her going just because I want to try to bring in the moolah. So, what do we need for Linlin? Terrain is absolutely a-okay, other than a little bit more grass. There we go, good stuff. And we need some plant coverage. Yeah, this is not going to look how I had it in my head, but that's okay. It's the fun of campaign mode. But we're still going to try and make it look cool. Asia! Right, so. So. I like the idea of the cherry blossoms. Have like a little cherry blossom bit down here. Maybe a river going along there. And then a bridge. And then there's like another cherry blossom. What would you call it? An orchard? An orchard of cherry blossoms? I have no idea. But we're going in hard on the cherry blossoms. Okay, let's put in that little bit of a river now as well. Just so I know what I'm doing. The mountains may be a little bit big because I can't see a bloody thing. That's okay. Sights for nerds. Lin Lin, I think you're gonna get a pot in a box, love. I'm sorry. No, you're okay. Wait, what are you obstructed by? Yeah, okay, I can see why. Let's knock that down a little bit further. Make this a little bit smaller. Here we go. We're finally gonna be. This is the mission we were doing before our big break for the Arctic pack. So it is kind of a long time coming, to say the least. I'm quite excited to see what the game has in store for us next. Unfortunately, we have had a bit of a spoiler, it should be said, for certain characters because of the said Arctic campaign, but that's okay. It's not exactly a negative spoiler, is it? Lin Lin, really? He wants us to go hard on the plants. I'm okay with that. I like the idea of making this quite a dense-looking forest, actually. Should provide, like, really good shelter for her as well. Like, she's not going to get nervous about anything. Because at the end of the day, right, she's here, she's in Brazil, it's not exactly her homeland or anything like that. She needs somewhere she's going to feel safe and protected. So if we can make it feel like she can hide away within, you know, plant life that she would have back home, then that's not a bad thing. I've got your back, Lin Lin. Don't you worry, girl. Don't really know what I'm doing, if I'm honest. But it's okay. We just keep sticking stuff in and hoping for the best. Just build little foresty bits. Up here, maybe. Yeah. All of these maple trees are pretty cool as well. Do I want them in there? I do not. No. Oh, get some broken ones in there, though. Very cool. Very sexy. 17%. We're very slowly getting there. There's some elms. The elms are pretty cool. Nice and tall. There we go, there we go. Let's build a little bit of an elm forest here at the back. Oh, and some lily pads, that's what we need. I should put the rocks in first, because that's usually how I do this, but if I assume I'll have a rock in the middle of the water, because I literally always do, we can safely put the lily pads right here as well. I really like the water lilies. I so rarely get to use them. Stop dropping down. Every now and again, I don't know how you set it, but when you put plant life in, it won't drop down to the bottom. Like you can see here when actually now it's instantly working. This is kind of a perfect example of what I was talking about. It was dropping back down to the bottom of the water every time, but now, for some reason, it's decided to stick to the top. That's a lot better. It makes things a lot quicker for me, but I also don't really understand why it happens, if I'm honest. I'm gonna do like a bridge of water. This is where we're gonna put the bridge. The bridge is going to go over this big water lily area. It's not, it's actually not like, okay, we have to put a lot of plants in for Lin Lin, but it's pretty nice, you know, we don't really feel limited in a way that we have with some other animals. There we are, back to the bottom. Although that may be because I swapped. See what I mean? It's not a big deal or anything, it's just, I'm just curious more than anything else, like why, what triggers it essentially? Life is weird. Okay. This is looking odd. I think the colour, the lighting isn't helping right now. We're kind of doused in shadow, and obviously that mountain needs a lot of love, but I just want to get the plants in so Lin Lin is happy, and then we'll go from there. Can I get some wisteria in here? I've had it looking super weird. Align the surface. Yeah, why not? We're going for like a magical kind of theme. Apparently that just means sticking with stereo everywhere. It's a weird thing, isn't it? It's like in shape-wise, it's peculiar. It really is. Maybe we just need some bamboo. I feel bamboozled. Where's my bamboo at? Oh, and a rosebush. These are my favourite rosebush. This actually might be my favourite plant in the game. It's definitely up there. The Guelda rosebush. I don't know why, but there's just something about it. It's very cool. Just, they're beautiful. These big white roses. It's amazing. Where's my bloody bamboo at? There it is. Not really left any room for this. We'll do it, like, up here. She's not going to go up here, but she doesn't know that. I can ruse her. I'm often known for my rusing of pandas. It's like a bamboo cluster. Up here at the top. And we are very close to our number. It's fine. This looks a little weird to me, but bamboo is kind of usually like this. It's very, you know, controlled in some ways. Especially in a zoo, I guess. How much bamboo do you need? Come on, Lin Lin, bloody Nora. 28, come on. There we go. It's a bit weird, but she's happy. Let's get her. Oh, what we should also be doing, I have no money whatsoever, is vet research on Lin Lin. Who's my highest ranked? They are both rubbish. See how she auto pops out now? It's really cool. They actually changed that recently. The unboxing now happens automatically. Habitat? What? Oh, temperature. Too hot. Yes. Okay, that makes sense. Okay. Oh god, I wish I had more money. Right, okay, we can sort this. So, habitat, species, giant panda. Maybe she can share some stuff with the snow leopard. That would help my life quite a lot. It's got a block of ice. Alright, we need some coolers. I don't think she probably wants it to be too cold, but I'll just put them in and we'll go from there. We're also going to need a water control thingy. Gift box enrichment. Do we have any food enrichment at all? No. Got a water bowl. Please tell me we've got a normal feeder. I don't trust anyone with arboreal feeding platforms. They never use them. They just never use them at all. It's bizarre. But there we go. That should be a little bit better. How are we feeling, Lin Lin? Where are we at? We're getting there. Enrichment's kind of rubbish, but we'll work on that. She's happy enough is the point, is the key point, really. Let's get some donation boxes in here. Everyone should be coming to see Lin Lin. She's my big gold girl. And I need to work on the rest of the exhibit. Right, so I think we're going to pull up here. This is meant to be a mountain, not some weird holy thing. I couldn't think of anything. A colander. There we go. It's a mountain and not a colander. In case you were curious that I was building a giant colander in my giant panda exhibit. I wasn't. That'd be weird. The idea... The problem is I put some trees there. That's okay. This looked so much cooler in my head. The problem is I can't like commit like insane amount of times to campaign mode. But I still want it to look cool. Maybe it will. Maybe we can turn this around. I kind of want some snow in here. Lin Lin okay with the snow? She should be, right? Okay. We got some lights going. It's the mountains are bigger than I wanted. I wanted this to be much more staggered. Maybe I should bring them down about there instead. Yeah. Get some light in here. You know, it's too dark. That's much better. Much better. It's looking pretty nice, actually. I'm going to build like a little land bridge. Oh, no, I'm not. Okay, cool. Right. What's going on? Anything bad? Nope. Nothing I care about. The bongo looks low welfare, but it will actually be totally okay. Lin Lin, my dear, where have you gone? Lin Lin? Lin Lin, there you are. Are you happy? How are we doing? Can you escape, more importantly? No. Cool. Right. So, construction. We're going... Theme. East Asia, very cool. And I want a bridge, first of all. Where's the bridge? I don't know. I just type brr. There it is. It's unfortunately a little bit too small. Huh. okay. If I get rid of the water, am I... What you should do with the water is get rid of it and then see if you can put it back, which we can, which is cool. It's triggered Lin Lin again. Lin Lin's constantly a little bit on the triggered side, it seems, but that's okay. There we go. Put the water back in, hopefully. Yep, good stuff. Construction. Bridge. There we go. Nice. Do we have any lights? Lights would be cool. Animals will fight due to overcrowding. Did one of my snow leopards grow up? I guess so. Meow, what's going on? Oi, get along with each other. You're an endangered species. Stop it. Stop fuming. We've got two females. Yeah, so who's the... There we go, there we go. You two have been getting on for your entire lives, and now one over last, your child grows up, so you feel the need to beat each other up. Stupid snillabits. Anyways, that's cute. That's cute. I'm going to put one of those in. I'm just going to put more of these in, because these are cool. They're a theme now, I've decided. I want a boat. I want a lamppost as well. The lamppost, we're going to do like a little path of going through the forest using the soil. I don't know where it goes or why, but we're leaning into it. It leads to the door, there we go. And what we can do then is light it with the lampposts. For fun, you see. Little Lynn loves being boxed up. She loves it, she does. Okay, we need to turn off a line. A line's rubbish. A line's like the worst thing in the world. There we go. Looks a little spooky, a little bit The Grudge, but yeah, that's pretty cool. And we need another bridge, another dirt path going over to the food and the water. So over here somewhere. She might need a little bit more grass or something now that I've done that, but that's okay. How you feeling, Lynn? My beautiful girl? How you doing? You good? You pooping? Looks like you're pooping. Oh, you okay? Good stuff. Right. More lights! I want some on the trees, I think. Like, just, I don't know. Does that look stupid? Let's find out. It might look stupid. They're huge, aren't they? They don't look that big, and then you grab them, and they're massive. I'm gonna hide. Okay, maybe not. And back to a line off. A couple of lampposts over there. I like these as well. I like everything. Everything is cool. I'll stick to the stone ones inside though, because that's what we've been using so far. It's looking nice. It's not a billion miles away from what I wanted. It's not exactly what I wanted either, but it's not a million miles away. The idea was to have a bridge going across this top bit, but I didn't realise the bridge was so small, and I'm not sure we have the stuff to actually make our... Never mind. Here we go. It's what we're going to use, I guess. We're going to make a big old bridge. Interesting. I'm surprised this isn't like construction. As in it doesn't, you know, latch onto a grid or something. So we're going to have to do a little bit of finagling ourselves. That's okay. Finagling's cool. Let's try to get that nice and straight, if possible. Shifted a little bit to the right. Oh, quite a lot to the right. That will be why. Obviously, it's not going to float by the end. I hope. I hope it won't float by the end. We'll have to wait and see. That's the fun, folks. That's the fun. And then we should be able to just duplicate this one and rotate it with angle snap. And then shift it over to the right. And we're looking pretty good. Good stuff. Can I then... Do I have anything to... How do I... Let's go up. Interesting. How do you do the bottom of the bridge? I get how you do one wall, because this matches... ish with it, right? It's not actually the same texture, but it's close. But then how do you do this side? It's too big. Is there a smaller one? There's actually a good way to do this, because this is obnoxious. There's gotta be, right? Am I going nuts? There's a good chance I've gone nuts. What am I missing? How do you do this? Is that it? Do you see my problem right now? There must be something going on. There must be a... Maybe I'm just not allowed. Maybe that is how tall the bridge has to be. I just figured there would be like, you know, something like this, but the equivalent for the bridge, so I can make it nice and tall, but... If there is, I'm not seeing it. Oh, sweet. Never mind. I didn't expect that, I've got to be honest.
I must admit, I'm quite relieved. With all that toxic waste around here, I was getting quite worried about you not making enough of a profit for me. I jest, of course. But you did it. You're a bit of a financial wizard. I should have you do my accounts. And I mean the real ones. And you really impressed the inspector, didn't you? She was very surprised to see a panda here. But I think Lin Ning should probably go back home soon. This was just a short holiday for her. Extremely short. Almost as if she was never here. So if people ask, she was never here. She's done her job, though. Show the world you've got a panda, and suddenly people who weren't taking your calls are actually calling you. They can open a lot of doors, pandas. Literally. They've sort of got thumbs, you know.
Myers, have you seen what I've been building here, son? You want me to just get rid of Lin Ling? It's not happening, buddy boy. It's not happening. Building her a freaking castle, and you're here telling me that she's only here as a temporary measure. No, 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 sir. So what, he's obviously in cahoots with someone a little bit shady, and he wanted support for his... This is nonsense. For his, zoo build, maybe he wants an investor or something like that, so he shows off the panda, and then they're impressed, and then he gets some cash, which is obviously what Maya's main prerogative always has been. Is there any way for me to do this where it doesn't look nonsensical? Because the bridge is thick, you know? Maybe I bring it up from this back wall, because I want the overhang. I don't want to block off this water here. But I also don't want the bridge to look like it's floating, really, so... I'm really surprised we got that profit, because I thought I'd been spending quite a lot of money, but this is what I mentioned in the last video, you know, Lin Lin, she's bringing in the moolah, what can I say? Where's my beloved chisel? I've not chiseled in ages. I love chisel. Look at it, it's beautiful. It ruins things in the best way. Get nice and flat, let's go in there a little bit, let's go in here, this is malarkey up here, what's all this? I have severe hiccups, I'm trying to hide them with my word talking, it's not working. There we go, make it sexy, make it sexy, it's too sexy, go back, we've gone too far. Well, you're not taking my Lin Lin, I'll tell you that much. There we go. It's not the worst thing I've ever built, it's not the best thing I've ever built, it's not the worst thing I've ever built. I think it's kind of cute, right? Oh, we did the mission, but we'll hang around for a little bit because it's only 22 minutes. What I would like to do is, because this is nice and high up, if you think what we'll do as well is flatten along there. The bridge definitely doesn't have the height that I kind of wanted it to have, but what are you going to do? Do we have any coolers up here? Coolers. Because what I'd love to do is sink that into the ground a little bit. Let's get some snow on this top level. Because we're in the middle of Brazil, and I think it's cool to have snow in the Brazilian rainforest. It's interesting. Can we just call it interesting? Where's my rock at? Now, a lot of this will be snow, but the actual mountain should be more inherently rocky anyway. We'll put the snow over the top of that, but that's going to help it blend in a lot, I think. Do the same back here. It was never really thematically going to fit in that much, but I think it would look even worse if you tried to... See, I think that's cool. I think it would look worse if you tried to do a... like a rainforest-inspired exhibit for the panda. I think that would look a bit bizarre, so... do I want to do a waterfall? I do want to do a waterfall. Waterfalls are cool. Oh, I also want a pagoda. I don't know why I'd build that, though. Also, I don't know how. I don't know how to build anything. We just do like a little hut, like a simple shape. It's like a square. Give it a hat. Give a square a hat, and you're basically done. That's my theory. I don't know where it's going to go. There's no room. I'm going to flatten this little bit. Ah, that's what I'll do. We're going to raise up here. I'm going to flatten. I want it to stick up above the bridge a little bit at least, right? So it's going to sit on there. I don't know what it's gonna be. It's just gonna be a stone hut, if I'm totally honest, but stone huts can be cool. It needs a door. Nice. Sexy. Can I give it a clay roof? Sort of. No. Maybe. It's a little bit on the big side. Maybe a nice. Okay, what am I doing? I'll figure it out. I will, eventually. I want it the other way, actually. Like that. What we can do is remove that from the group, move it a little bit that way. That's a little bit too far. Bring it back. And then I grab it and duplicate it and move it out to about there. That is the stupidest thing in the world. It just looks bizarre. Oh, little hut. What will I do with you, little hut? God only knows. I want a cart. Hutman has a cart. That's all we know about Hutman. There's a lamppost as well. That's all we know about Hutman. There's a window. That's all we know about Hutman. I'll stop eventually, I promise. I think I actually meant to put that over a window. I just kind of like the red. I think the red's cool. There's a monkey as well. Hutman praises the monkeys. We'll go with that. You could do like a see no evil, hear no evil, speak no evil kind of thing with these guys. They're nearly there. You'd have to cover their eyes or something. Hutman is not a man. Hutman is a panda. There we go. And he watches over Lin Lin from his little hut on the hill. Him and the monkeys. There we go. It's a masterpiece, I think we can all agree. Right, let's try to get a little bit of water. Let me think about this. This is not the right shape for a waterfall at all. Need to dig in, and then we're gonna go flatten, and we're gonna dig in like so, and the water will tumble out there. Sweet. Okay, construction, water. Oh, we do a water wheel. Now, the water wheel actually has like tons of stuff, like cabinets and stuff like that, and I actually, off the top of my head, have no idea how that would work. So I'm just gonna stick the water wheel in, and it's gonna look cool, and the cabinet's gonna sit somewhere. I actually have no idea. One day I'm gonna build the water wheel though, it's gonna be cool. Put a little shrine up there. I mean, I still think it looks cool. It doesn't necessarily make any sense whatsoever, but it is cool. I'll put it there. The further back it is, the less nonsensical it looks. Okay, and we need to get rid of East Asia. Not rid of East Asia, that would be a little bit harsh. Waterfall top. Waterfall midsection. This is the problem you always get. Are you aligning? Yeah, if we turn off a line. Bring it out. Okay, it's pointing the wrong way, but that's fine. That's actually good, so we're going to grab it. And rotate that bad boy. Okay, I'm a little confused, not going to lie. What's going on here? I am perplexed. I'm a little bit perplexed. I'm just going to align it to there. There we go, there we go, there we go. That was easy. Waterfall bottom. Waterfall booty, as it's known. About there. Okay, that's a little bit out of alignment. Yeah, you can tell. I'm going to drag that to the right. And I'm also going to duplicate it and drag it down again. No, enough. Okay. Good stuff. Now we need snoo. And then we're done. Snoo. 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 Okay. There we go. Lin Lin's little Asian habitat. Lovely stuff. And we're done. We got our profit. We made moolah. Lin Lin, how are you feeling, my dear? She's chilling. She's eating her bamboo. Oh, Nope. Sorry. Lin Lin, I'm sorry. I'm not trying to quarantine you. Oh, she's adorable, though. She's munching. I'm gonna munch. Lin Lin, that is perfect for the thumbnail. I thank you very much. You're a doll, an absolute doll. Go, oh, what is this nonsense? Go away. My problem is she's sitting in the, oh my God. She's sitting in the darkness a little bit. She's kind of a pain. Look at her. The cutest. Can we light her up maybe? No, Lin Lin, don't stop. Lin Lin, look what I gave you. Oh God, Lin Lin, I'm sorry. Lin Lin, no. That's my bad, slightly. Right. But I mean, this isn't exactly how I planned it. You know, nobody ever plans to have a mountain panda statue with its macaw friends watching over Lin Lin. But we got the hill with the mountain, we got a bridge, we got another little bridge over the lily pads, we got the waterfall, we got the blossoms. We've got the bamboo, which looks a little daft with those trees next to it, I'd say. It's vaguely similar to what I had in mind. At the end of the day, we have finished the mission. So, what we're going to do is we're going to save up. We're going to head to the main menu. And we're going to have a cheeky little peek at what is coming in the next video. I believe we have 3 or 4 missions left. I'm actually not that sure. It's taken us a long time to work through the campaign, I'll acknowledge. But I've enjoyed it. It's been nice to have it something to come back to. It's a nice break. It's a nice way to play Planet Zoo without having to play franchise mode. I love franchise mode, or sandbox mode as we are now. But it's a little intense. 4 left still. Hiring freeze at the Myers Sunshine Happiness Zoo. That's a name and a half. Myers Sunshine Happiness Zoo promises a lot. Alright, cool. So it's a big snowy zoo. It actually looks really cool. I'm excited about that. And that's going to take us up here to the North Pole looking spot. There we go. All my gold animals. In a little Oh god, they all turn to look at you. That's terrifying. Anyways, we're going to end it there. Thank you so much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way. I'll see you next time.